Hello friends. So for many of you who are watching this video for the very first time, welcome to my channel. This is Nisha and I'm an animal activist. I have been rescuing and rehabilitating so many dogs and cats for the past 7 years. For me to start this YouTube channel and to come in front of you, the reason is to actually connect with so many other rescuers like me around the world, and this will also help me to help more animals in need. That's the sole reason. And today I'm gonna share with you the rescue story of Ruby, a lab. Why her rescue story is because her rescue story has been very close to my heart, actually. And she was with us for a very short period of time, but she really got close to me and my hubby. And so here it goes. How it went is, actually I have a 1 year old baby who sleeps very late in the night, sometimes 3 a.m. or 4 a.m. So I usually sleep according to his schedule. And one day around 2:30 in the night, I was just going through the pound page in Facebook, and I just found out somebody had posted that there has been a lab which has been abandoned in Annanagar. And it was quite nearby my house, and I was like, oh my god, this is near my place. And I immediately contacted that person in Messenger, and he said, yes, the lab is with us and we don't know what to do. So I immediately packed up whatever food I had, you know, dog food or milk, whatever I had, and I rushed to the spot in the middle of the night. And I saw it was like office premises and two streets away from my house, and they had secured the lab, and she was so beautiful. And I didn't know what to do. And when I saw around, I saw another breeder who was standing right next to us and who wanted to take the dog. But then I had to act fast. I said, okay, fine, I'll take the responsibility of the dog. You can hand over the dog to me. I took her. I went around the area in the middle of the night thinking that somebody will be searching for her, but unfortunately, there was no one searching for her, and it was only me and the dog running around the entire area. So I brought her home, and I fed her dog food, chicken, rice, milk, water, whatever I could, and she hogged as if she hasn't eaten food for so many days. I don't know, poor soul, for how long she has been on the streets, and when did her actual owner abandon her. I posted about her everywhere in social media and everywhere, but nobody claimed. I saw people posting in my initial post like, oh my god, thanks for rescuing, and you know, everything. But then I didn't see anybody claiming as owner, so I was a bit worried about what exactly is there for her. The next day, you know, actually my husband was very supportive. Next day, myself and my hubby took Ruby to nearby veterinary hospital, ARC. Dr. Arvind actually examined her and said that she's quite healthy and fine, she's fit. Where do you find her? Then we told him the entire story. He was quite surprised. And then we brought her home. Initially she didn't get along with our dogs, but then later on she got along. She was with us for a week. We took her for walks, fed her, played with her, everything.
Okay.
It was quite difficult, to see how people just abandon the dogs once they are overplaying with, or once they have done breeding, or they have got puppies out of it and everything. But then, yes, it was difficult for us because I had to manage 3 dogs and 6 cats and a 1-year-old baby at home. All have been my rescues over years, and yeah, what can I do? Then came, it was the darker times where after a week my hubby met with a major accident where he had had a major injury in his right hand. He almost lost his entire right hand. I had to rush him to the hospital because there was so much blood loss, and when the doctor examined, he said the muscles and nerves which are connecting to the heart have been cut, so we need to get him plastic surgery done or whatever we could to stop bleeding. So I completely panicked, and it was very stressful. But then we had to take a decision right away, and yes, we proceeded with the surgery. And after 2 to 3 hours of surgery, doctor said yes, he is fine, and he can be discharged after a week. But then I had to run around hospital and the house. I had to nurse my husband, who was very sick. So then I decided to board Ruby in ARC NG boarding kennels. Dr. Arvind was so cooperative, and he took her in, and there she was boarded, and she was also sterilized in the meantime. And by then my husband had recovered, and it was at least more than 45 days by then. And I was shuttling around hospital, home, and ARC, and constantly going and meeting Ruby. And I actually forgot to say how I named her Ruby. The day I brought her home, I just saw her eyes. They were just sparkling, like rubies. And that's when we decided, yes, she has to be called Ruby. And yes, since then she was Ruby, and even till date she has been called by the same name by her new family. It was very difficult for me to manage the situation, but then we did. Finally, it was time for me to give her up for adoption. It was a very difficult decision for me to take, but then I had to, for her well-being. I had posted her pictures in Pound Facebook page and Pet Pals Hindu newspaper. She was only 1 to 1.5 years old, and she was at the right age for adoption. We were searching for a good family. One day I got a call from this person's telling, we are really interested in taking Ruby in. Would you like to, give us Ruby? Then I said, yeah, why not? Sure. So I got to know them. They first met Ruby at ARC, where she was boarded, and they really liked her. They were a genuine dog loving family. Then we went once to meet them with Ruby, and it was fun. Yes, Ruby really liked them. They also got along with Ruby so well. They took Ruby for walks, and Ruby was about to get 2 more friends, 1 lab and a golden retriever, which the new family already had. And they were so welcoming and so nice. They were genuine dog lovers. We really liked them, and they also liked us.
Thank you.
And but then they had to go for a vacation, so Ruby was again back in ARC. And then so one fine day, the new family was ready to take her in, and myself and my husband again drove her. We took her from ARC, Dr. Arvind, manager Parthiban, Karthik, and other staff were so nice, and they had taken very good care of Ruby. She was fit, hale, healthy, and she was all set to go to her new home. And yes, it was very difficult for me to give her up for adoption, since it was a very short time, but she has got along with us very well. But then she had to be given up, and we drove her all the way to the new family. And it was difficult, but then when we actually reached there, they were very welcoming, and Ruby also got along with her other two friends so well. Ruby's a little shy now, and she is not willing to talk to you guys. You can see her. She's like enjoying her ride. She's very cute, and she's gonna get a very loving family soon. Right, Ruby? Ruby, look at here. Look at here, baby. Look at here. Ruby. Okay, she's a little shy, okay? Today, to see Ruby so happy with her new family, it actually helps me understand that yes, it was worth it. And yeah, I'm very happy to see Ruby finally, get on with her life. I would only like to say, for those people who abandon their dogs, you actually don't know what you're doing. It's just a matter of time. You just play with the dog like a doll, and you cannot just abandon it. It's a life which you are abandoning. Will you abandon your kid if you don't like it? So I don't know. I don't know what else to say. I'm so happy for Ruby, actually. You can definitely see the video, which I'm gonna share now. her being very happy with the new family and everything. So thank you so much for watching this video, and I hope this helps me connect with other fellow animal rescuers around the world. And thank you so much for all the other rescuers and other organizations who have been doing this. I really appreciate, and God bless you all. And if you really like Ruby's story, and if you really like our work, please do like this video and subscribe to my channel. And do inbox me if you'd like to connect with me, and this will also help me save other animals in need. And thank you so much, friends. Thank you so much.